Hey guys, Amanda here. I hope this finds you well. Today I wanted to share with you 4 tips I have for choosing a hiking-specific rain jacket. Tip number 1, first you need to decide what level of weather resistance is going to be appropriate for you on your hike. A couple things to think about. Do you want something waterproof and breathable, which will serve to keep the rain out in addition to moving sweat away from your body and back out into the world? This provides for the most protection from both precipitation and perspiration. Another alternative is a water-resistant jacket, an option for less wet climates you may be hiking through. These are typically very breathable as well. And finally, we have a waterproof, non-breathable choice, which is going to be your best and most affordable option as an emergency poncho or something you only need for short periods of time, such as if hiking through an intermittent downpour in an otherwise dry climate. Tip number 2, once you decide on your weather resistance, you want to decide on your type of wind protection as well. Waterproof jackets are going to be equally windproof, but you can also opt for a water-resistant windproof option. Wind-resistant types are going to be your lightest weight option and also most easily to compress down and stash in your pack and tuck away for easy storing. So these are going to be ideal for short trips and more optimal weather conditions. Tip number 3, you want to choose the type of weather shell most appropriate for you. When I talk about shell, I mean hard shell, soft shell, hybrid shell, and insulated shell options. Hard shells are going to be your waterproof, breathable, but not insulated options, while soft shell options include an insulating layer with a water-resistant shell. So those offer less protection from the rain, but more breathability. Hybrid jackets combine the best of both worlds of soft and hard shells, so a great option if you're looking for a little bit of both. And finally, your insulated shells are going to be those that provide you with the most warmth, as they're filled with a certain degree of down or synthetic insulation, and they're traditionally water resistant and breathable, but not always waterproof, so you want to look into that and decide whether or not being completely waterproof is going to be the best way for you to go. Finally, you want to choose whether or not a DWR treatment is going to be right for you, and often how many times you'll need to apply and reapply it to your jacket of choice. Your DWR is your durable water repellent finish and provides for kind of a coating that prevents moisture from soaking through the fabric. And it also makes precipitation bead off and roll off so it doesn't stay on your jacket. Quickly to recap, 4 tips I have for you for choosing a hiking specific rain jacket. First and foremost, you want to decide the type of weather resistance appropriate for you, choosing between waterproof and breathable, water resistant and breathable, waterproof and non-breathable. Tip number 2, you can choose different types of wind protection in addition to water protection. So while your waterproof jackets are equally windproof, you can also get a variation of wind resistance, such as a water resistant windproof option. And then your wind resistant types are going to be your lightest weight, most compressible types that pack down for easy storing and are best for short trips and optimal weather. There, just kind of as a backup piece of protection. Tip number 3, you want to choose the type of shell most appropriate for you, whether that be a hard shell, a soft shell, a hybrid shell, or an insulated shell. And finally, you'll need to decide whether or not your jacket is going to require a durable water repellent DWR coating, and if so, how often. Your DWR coating is the finish that provides for the prevention of water actually soaking through that fabric. So it's pretty important and optimal for waterproof type jackets. Those are the 4 tips I have for you when picking out a hiking specific rain jacket. I'd love to hear any additional tips you might have, or if one of these in particular really helps you make a decision. And then, as always, any general feedback in the comments section below. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys next time.
Hey guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you like connecting with other outdoor enthusiasts, you should definitely consider checking out Summit. Summit is a social network that brings together adventure junkies from all around the world to exchange stories, share advice, and inspire each other. You might even make some new friends, too. It's kind of like Facebook for outdoorsy people, but with better privacy, no ads, no spam, and tons of extras. You can join Summit by going to summit.theadventurejunkies.com or by clicking the link in the description below. You can find me in Summit, too, so be sure to say hi when you join.